Hello, I'm Cosimo. ZMT just provided me with the latest software release, version 7.2, of their computational life science platform, Sim4Life. Today, I will test some of the new features. I'm curious how the code will perform. The core new features are the image-based creation of personalized anatomical head models, the automatized placement of electrode templates of the head according to the international 10-10 system, the support for modulated exposure, and the coupling of modulated exposure with induced effects, such as tissue heating or neurostimulation. I want to see if I can do some personalized modeling of transcranial electric and magnetic stimulation. First, let's create a personalized head model based on input from magnetic resonance imaging image data. Sim4Life 7.2 now supports almost fully automated segmentation with a mixture of artificial intelligence in the form of deep neural networks and classic computer vision techniques. It would be impressive if that just works out of the box. Here you see how I import T1 and T2 image data into Sim4Life, configure and launch the head model generation. The software used AI to distinguish 16 different tissue classes, including air internal, artery, bone cancellous, bone cortical, cerebrospinal fluid, gray matter, white matter, dura, eyes, mucosa, rectus muscles, skin, spinal cord, vein, visual nerve, and other tissues. This didn't take too much time, and I'm happy with the results. In the next step, I use the newly released Sim4Life tool to place an electrode template according to the 10-10 system. The tool only requires the locations of our fiducials and an electrode template. I execute the placement by first creating the 10-10 system locations and then placing correctly oriented copies of the selected entities at the locations I want. It's really easy. The possibility to easily create personalized head models is an important step towards treatment planning when standard heads are not sufficient. For example, for any of the non-invasive brain stimulation modalities, such as transcranial electric stimulation, transcranial magnetic stimulations, temporal interference stimulation, or focused ultrasound. Another very useful addition of version 7.2 is the support for modulated exposure. I would like to test this to analyze safety-relevant heating peaks and how spiking is initiated in layer 5 pyramidal neurons by both TES and TMS. Let's give it a try. I have already performed quasi-static low-frequency simulations of both TES and TMS. Here you see the induced electric field for TES and here the one for TMS. Now I use one of the new modulation tools to attach the transient pulse shape to the electromagnetic field. There are only two pre-configured pulse shapes available in the drop-down menus. They could still be improved by ZMT. But I read somewhere that one can easily create arbitrary pulses. Now my 3D quasi-static field is turned into amplitude-modulated exposure. The modulated field becomes available as a time-dependent heat source in my thermal simulation. I ran the simulation and it finished suspiciously quickly. I thought I made a mistake somewhere, but everything is fine. Apparently, the thermal simulator now benefits from graphics processing unit acceleration, resulting in simulations that are up to 100 times faster. That's kind of a game changer for thermal simulations and make a difference for sure. Earlier, I placed a point sensor in the simulation and I now inspect it to see the transient temperature evolution at the location. There are thermal ripples resulting from the pulsed exposure, but I can conclude that the temperature increase is too small to be of concern. Finally, I also want or need to check how modulated exposures can be applied to study neural responses. For that purpose, I have distributed a few layer 5 pyramidal, which are believed to be fundamental with regard to supra-threshold TMS, throughout relevant parts of the cortex at an appropriate depth. Again, I use the new feature to apply a modulated exposure, this time based on the magneto-quasi-static MQS simulation, as my source for a T-neuro simulation. Let's run the simulation and inspect the result. As you can see, spiking is induced in some of the pyramidal neurons. I'm quite impressed how straightforward it was to get to this result. Pretty cool. Thank you for joining for this video. I hope you have enjoyed looking at some of the advanced new features of Sim4Life version 7.2 and that you are now curious to explore them yourself. Big thanks also to ZMT for providing me with the new version in advance of the release. See you next time!